Okay, so today we are going to discuss about ethical issues in educational intervention, okay, which is which has a great impact. Without ethical issue, without you know, the code of conduct, we cannot teach and we cannot prepare educational mappings or interventions, because it is very, very important. We have to see values, we have to see integrity, the respect, and the code of conduct if you want to prepare. Okay, as we were discussing about classroom management involves it encourages the student to change their behavior. This behavior can be changed or modified until unless you don't work on your intervention. So to prepare an intervention, you need to check it out. You need to go through the process, and we are going to take one process which is called ethical issues. We need to understand what are the code of ethics we need to remember, we need to consider before we plan or implement the intervention. So what are the things before and during we need to remember while preparing the educational intervention? The first one is a model appropriate leadership, which is very important. See here, the student must see the educator's behavior positive. In educational intervention or in teaching, the children, the student, they see the teacher and behave the behave as it is. If the teacher is behaving good, they will model the teacher, or they will model those learning, those objectives, how the teacher does. So student must see the educator's leadership, positive leadership, appropriate leadership, so that it reflects in your child. So to do this, the educator must develop the good relationship, a genuine relationship, trust, caring, respect with the child. Okay, then only the model of his or her behavior, your child's behavior, can be changed or can be modified. So everything, whatever the activity you select for preparing the educational intervention, make sure that it reflects towards your appropriate leadership. You model that particular object in a such a way so that the child can grab something from that what you do, which is very, very important. It helped. The teacher must help to pull their students to reach to the a threshold level or reach the objective. That is the first ethical issues which we need to understand, which is called your appropriate leadership. Then second one is a self-discipline. Now self-discipline also plays a major role, because self-discipline is a goal of intervention where the teacher should encourage it in the classroom. Whatever the intervention you take for the classroom or for the individual, make sure that works, that goes, that implement with a discipline, with a appropriate way, so that the child can encourage towards that objective and they learn something through that. So by building this respect and the trust, the student will begin to feel the need to control his or her own behavior. Here the behavior is nothing but the learning, the change in the attitude, the change in the, or something, well, what the child learns. Okay, behavior is nothing but an action where the child learns something. So this respect and trust can foster a positive interaction among the teachers, among the peer groups, among the parents. So the objective, whatever you select, must implemented with self-discipline, in it, the teacher. You know, when you go to the classroom, you try to teach the children that you, in this way, you're going to perform. You're not going to do, you know, you're not going to talk with your friends when I speak. Or you must have the, you know, anticipatory set where, you know, you give the rules, you make the child understand what is my rules, what will be my consequences when I teach in the classroom. When you have to ask the question, or, you know, for example, if, you know, the child is sharpening his or her pencil during the lesson. So that is against your rule, because you have, you know, explained the child, you need to do all this before starting the class. When you have the transition time, you must think over that my pencil, my textbook, my, you know, notebook, everything should be on the table. So the rules, the procedures involved, every teacher must involve in the classroom to foster the child's positiveness or positive interaction. Then we have experiences, match experience to the students. Now, what is this? Now here, as you can see, you know, children should have a positive experience in the classroom. Whatever the objective, whatever the, you know, and the goal or domain which you select for the children to perform in the classroom or sometime in the, you know, a resource room, what happens is, you know, it should be, you know, they must experience something positive, energetic, and experience is usually, you know, like, you know, it should be within the development of the age of the child. If you give something else experience, for example, the child is in fifth grade and you're trying to teach something which is happened to be in 10th or 12th, where the child, you know, not understanding, you know, sometimes that is meaningless. So make sure that whatever the content you have selected, that should be a meaningful, that should be under the developmental or appropriate towards the developmental stage of the child. It should have some meaningful experience, you know, to the children, so that,
and even can... parents' consent also.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're right. So next one is about your, you know, as you said, the consent is very, very important. The confidentiality is very, very important before you prepare your, you know, implement your intervention. So you need to take the parent consent. The educator should be sure to notify those involved with the child of the intervention management procedure. For example, if you are involving the special educators, the medical officers, the inclusion champion, the governor, directors, or any other stakeholder, you know, involved in the development or in the process of intervention management of the child, you need to give the tell the parents or take the consent from the parent that this other activity we are going to, you know, teach your child. You must be aware. Take the signatures, tell the things, maintain the confidentiality on the paper, talk about, you know, the concerns, how you're going to handle at home. So all those things you need to, you know, must be planned before you, before you, you know, implement or plan your document. So you need to apply, you need to tell everything, or you need to take the signature of the parents on the IEP, on the intervention plan, or whatever the goal you are teaching. And anyways, you will be conducting the, you know, PTMs, you will be conducting the council, parent council meeting, you might be conducting the, you know, day meetings with the parents, where we say that every day, as a special educator, if you're working in the inclusive school, to build the relationship with the parents, you need to meet the parents every day. You need to schedule your timetable, meeting at least one parent in a day. if you have 30, 40 students. In that way, you can build the relationship. If not, the parent will come after 1 month and say, what you have taught my child? I'm not understanding when you don't have the regular interaction with the parents. So, you know, that's very, very important to take the consent about the, you know, intervention, whatever. Without acknowledgement of the parents, you must not start the process of intervention management. If not, if anything happens tomorrow, they are going to hold on you, they are going to sue you, they are going to ask many questions. And sometime what happens, you know, if it is, you know, if you have seen a drastic change in the child, tomorrow the parent will come and acknowledge you. If they see a negative, if they see a reverse way of things happening in the child, then they will again, you know, they will not listen to anybody. They will sue you. Then they are going to go with the legal way. So that things we must, you know, think, keep in our mind before we plan and before we implement, you need to concern. You know, this is what you do in your IEP meeting. This is what you do in your PTM. This is what you do in your counseling session. This is what you do, you know, when you interact with the parents. So this is
sir, about, in case like few, sir, in case few parents who don't like accept, or like if we try to show like there are some few symptoms of so and so, then they don't accept few parents, and like they will be like in a reverse reaction kind of like, no, it's okay, fine, means they don't want to accept and they're like, it's okay, let it be like that, my child type. So if he's there in the school, it's so, that's it, enough. We don't want to like work on that. It's okay. If it is, he's coming to school, that's okay.
Yes. Now see,
in that case, how far we can, we need to acknowledge parents that this is the thing you need to understand about child, or like, he can school, let him go. What do you suggest, sir?
See, in this case, you know what, see, when you deal with the, you know, uncooperative parent, I will say it is dealing with the uncooperative parents, because there will be some parent who will understand you, who will, you know, take all your points in positive way, and they will try to interact the, you know, their child in all the environment. What now your question is like, you know, dealing with uncooperative parents. So to deal with uncooperative parents where they don't understand, they don't accept, they don't follow, they don't. So what you have to do, you need to be very calm. First of all, when they come with you, they will come with the many questions to you, to your chamber. So make sure that don't bombard first time. This is what is now. Be calm. You feel relaxed to the parents. You first listen. You first listen what they are telling you, okay? This is what, how you're going to do. You listen whatever they say. Make sure that you have a scribbling pad, note down each and every point what they say, not from your mind. Whatever they say, if they say, this is my, I know my child is not understanding. My child is not understanding. Write down on the scribbling pad. If they say, you know, my child is having a difficulty during the you know, night time, right? So all those things, first you listen to the parents, you let them remove everything. If we interrupt in between, what happened, the argument goes to the next level. So make sure don't do that. Then once they finish, and you also keep in your mind, you know, when you have to stop the parent, when you should not stop the parent. Once they finish with it, then try to answer each and every question which they have asked you or which you have noted down. Okay, now you want to listen how, you know, you have said that my child is not having a, you know, a difficulty in this. Now, my child has a difficulty in this. Did you ever wonder why it's happening? So in that way, you need to counsel. So once you have, you know, written down, once you have explained the strength and weaknesses, make sure that, you know, You explain the strength and weaknesses. And finally, if you say that this is what your child is, if you want to accept it, go for that. Because we are not going to judge. We are not here to judge the things. It's up to you, because you are the parent. If you want to follow, you follow. And the final stage is you need to note, you need to give the information to the authority in the school. It might be a principal, it might be an administration, management, or any other people, those who are holding it. So this is how the procedure you need to follow. If not, because this is code of ethics which you need to follow when you deal in the school or in the classroom. If not, the uncooperative parents will not listen to you, and they will just stare. And because they love their child, where they don't want to listen any negative things. So you must be telling, you must counsel. That's what I said you in the initial. Every day if you meet a parent, 100%, you will see some changes. And it's quite natural where you cannot see the changes immediately. You need to come up with the things one by one, so that they can change their behaviors. This is what I think we can do. Okay, it's 12 now.
Yes, sir.